Hi, thanks for tuning in. In previous lessons, I've already shaped a little bit the picture of what Shopware is all about. But if you're coming from another platform, for instance, Magento, it might be useful to actually compare a couple of features between Magento and Shopware. And that's actually the entire goal of this lesson and a couple of other lessons coming up later. So let's do a comparison between Magento 2 and Shopware 6, kind of like an overview of a couple of aspects of the architecture of both. So let's dive into things. There's a couple of general points to make. It's a different kind of technology, obviously, between Magento and Shopware, but there's also some similarities. For instance, both are based upon Composer, both are written in PHP for the larger part. They make use of a little bit of JavaScript on the front end, etc., etc. And it's also nice to know that actually they're both extensible by using modules slash plugins. So actually, in Magento, we refer to modules, but in Shopware, we refer to plugins. And through a Shopware plugin, you can just modify various parts. And there's going to be plenty of lessons later on to dive into that matter. And simply put, every time when you want to modify something in either Magento or in Shopware, you first start with a little bit of XML to configure something. So for instance, dependency injection requires you to first make a definition in XML, and then later on you can write a PHP class for the actual functionality. And that same thing actually is true for Shopware as well. The only thing is that, well, Shopware is preferring XML, but Shopware is basing its own configuration upon the Symfony framework, and theoretically or also practically, you can also use YAML or PHP to do that same thing. But still, there's a configuration, and then actually the actual functionality in a PHP class follows. Now, zooming into the database, there's also a couple of differences that you need to know about. In Magento, most of the tables out there are based upon numeric primary keys, which is kind of like the default for MySQL anyway. However, Shopware is using UUIDs, 16-bit strings that are, well, kind of hard to remember because of their length. And that's leading into, well, its own challenges that normally you don't look up a primary key of some kind, but either you remember part of it, so maybe the first part or the last part of that UUID, or you find your way in another way to compare things within the database. So database management, simply because of those UUIDs, is handled with in a little bit of a different way. Another thing that is kind of interesting is that with Magento, indexing is a big thing. So you always need to make sure that the indexes are up to date and the indexes are performant in a live site. There also is this separate table usage for indexing. So simply by scanning all of the table names, there's always a couple of matches with the keyword index literally in them. And if you try to do that same thing within Shopware, you will not find such a table. There are still separate tables that are being influenced by indexers. But it also sometimes that an indexer is simply targeting an existing table, and therefore also a specific column within that existing table. It makes maybe indexing a little bit harder to grasp, but therefore there's also a separate lesson upon how to deal with indexing. I also have another lesson coming up on comparing more of those database features between Magento and Shopware. So stay tuned basically for more. This lesson is much more about shaping kind of like an overview. So let's focus upon a different topic, dependency injection. So again, there's a separate lesson on dependency injection with practical scenarios, where I'm actually going to go through things within Magento, like preferences, equaling in Shopware a service alias. There's basically a lot of similarities. It starts with a configuration, as mentioned before. Within Magento, that's a di.xml file. Within Shopware, that's normally a services.xml file. And then from within that configuration, you can just do stuff. There's DI types for injecting CLI commands. Well, in Shopware, we would use simply service tag, a Symfony service tag actually, to define such a CLI command. Within Magento, we can create DI plugins that actually generate so-called interceptor classes. Well, such a thing is not there in Symfony / Shopware, but actually if you would create a surface decorator, you would accomplish kind of like the same thing. So it's a little bit the same, but different. Again, there's a separate lesson tuning in on the specific DI features, where I'm actually going to run through practical code, showing you a little bit of code within Magento and then the corresponding code within Shopware. Another thing that maybe shows kind of like the differences between Magento and Shopware are the thing of extending an entity. Well, this is already assuming that there's actually a concept like an entity. So in Magento, we're using the database pattern called EAV, entity attribute value. And basically the word entity is used to distinguish between a flat table and an entity table, which is actually spread across multiple flat tables. Well, such an entity could be the product. Well, in Shopware, we do have products as well, obviously. However, the product table is actually not an EAV table. It's not spread out across multiple tables. It's a single table, making it fairly easy to understand the database structure. That's kind of like the baseline. But here in this slide, I'm actually talking about how to extend that entity. So how to extend upon a product. Well, within Magento, there's this principle of extension attributes, opposed to the other concept of EAV attributes, which are simply added to the database. And you could say that maybe the EAV attributes in the database are equaling so-called custom fields in Shopware, while actually extension attributes might equal entity extensions. And the principle is kind of like the same thing. You just bring in your own code and your own way of storing data in your own database tables. So to do that, you also need to come up with your own class. Within extension attributes, there's this XML layer which is suggesting that it's doing already a lot of different things. Well, that's basically a suggestion, but in reality, there's always a lot of work that you need to do to create a plugin class intercepting all of the methods of a specific repository, like the product repository. And therefore, it begins really simple, and then it quickly becomes really, really difficult. Within Shopware, an entity extension feels kind of like the same, but it actually has a different approach. There's always a lot of work to get started with, simply just because you need to extend upon this entity extension class and fill in all the blanks. So there's at first a lot of code to write. However, then to put everything into use, you only need a subscriber to just add your own entity extension on top of the entity. So there's literally a method called addEntity or addExtension to allow for this to happen. So extending an entity, at least you know that it's possible in Magento, and now you know also that it's possible within Shopware. Same, but well, a little bit different. On the JavaScript level, on the front end, but also on the back end, there's plenty to say as well. Within Magento, we use this modified version of knockout / require / jQuery, well, plus a lot of Magento stuff on top of it. And a lot of people that get started with Shopware say like, oh, but then the usage of Vue is a breeze. Well, I want to mention also that it's not just Vue out of the box. So a lot of the things that might be familiar for you as a Vue developer are done again a little bit differently in Shopware. So I'm often referring to a customized version of Vue because single file components and a couple of other things that are normal within regular Vue app development are actually not there in Shopware, or at least out of the box. Still, it is comparable. So there's plenty of JavaScript to play with. The stack that Magento is using is often heavier than the stack that Shopware is using. But maybe that's also related to the history and the age of Magento 2 versus Shopware 6. So Magento 2 is already 5-6 years old, or at least its stable version. And the Shopware 6 version is just out for a couple of years only. Well, we've gone through a couple of those different topics. There's obviously much more to tell about this, but in this little lesson, I simply wanted to show that, well, a lot of the features within Magento are comparable with features in Shopware. However, yeah, the devil is always in the details. So let's actually move on into other lessons and focus upon a couple of topics more intensively, just to see like what the real difference is all about, and also to come up with a couple of code comparisons. So stay tuned for more, and hope you liked it, and see you in a bit.